All right, let's have 15 minutes to get back to a place of truth. Let's start off by realizing that nothing we know of ourselves is what's actually going on, and that what is always going on is the fullness of God, the fullness of heaven. So no matter what we think, no matter what we do, no matter what our day looks like, our project looks like, our work, realize, our body, our mind, our everything, realize that what's actually happening as you, all the time, is the whole of God. The whole purpose of God, the whole presence of God, the whole light of God, perfection of God, presence of God. So just let's have a lot of silence right now, just to realize that everything about me that I think I am, that I know I am. All my ideas and my plans, my work, my presence, everything that I'm aware of isn't what's happening. What's happening is the full presence of God. You are that light, whether you know it or not, or I know it or not. No matter what we're doing, no matter if we think we're doing something spiritual, or we think we're doing something unspiritual, doesn't make any difference. What's actually happening as you, as your consciousness, is the fullness of God. So right now, give way to it. Stop knowing yourself. Reach into every major area of your life and realize that despite the way it looks or feels, despite its purpose, its impulse, its plans, its desires, its needs, all these are senses. Despite everything you know of yourself, and despite whether you feel you're being spiritual or unspiritual, what's actually and always happening is the fullness of God. So go ahead, reach into your life, explore your life, at least the 3, 4, 5 major areas, we might say. And realize that what's actually happening is the fullness of God. God is happening as you and as that, as him and as her and as it. The reason you're doing something isn't the reason at all. God is the reason. The purpose driving it isn't the purpose at all. God is the purpose. Whether we're praying or playing, God is actually the only thing happening. And when we are consciously aware of that, both when we're praying and when we're playing, then we are being a healing presence, a revealing presence. But of course, if we get caught up in what appears to be, then we're not. We're being material. We're being human. But being material, seemingly, being human, seemingly, with the awareness that actually I can't be. So even if I am being this moment, I can't be, because the only I that's happening is God. It's the conscious awareness of God is everything of my consciousness, everything of my thinking, everything of my activity that keeps the door open to this light, this revealing or healing light that reveals more and more of truth in and as everyone, everything, everywhere. So go ahead and explore your consciousness and re-evaluate, see it truthfully now instead of the way we normally would see it. Go and visit every important him, every important her in your life, every important thing, place in your life, activity, purpose in your life. And re-evaluate it, re-see it as truth right now. Begin to see it as your consciousness is actually being it. Truth. Think about someone in your life. And now realize that omniscience is actually being that person, aware of itself as you, as your awareness, despite what you think or I think. Realize omniscience is that person, and omniscience is your awareness happening as and of that person. Now give way to it. What do you think's really happening as that person? What do you think's really happening as your awareness of him or her? What do you think his or her purpose is here? And do you think that purpose is hindered by his or her awareness or your awareness? No, God is busy being God as that person, unhindered by what they think or you think. That mind, that body, is God happening, unhindered by what they think or what you think or I think. We're living a very foggy state of awareness of what's actually happening. God is the only thing happening. There's nothing human happening. It appears that way to the human consciousness that's creating the appearance. But there's no truth. Only God is happening. Only God is. And I am that. You are that. The I of you is that. So know that with your mind. Know it. And then give way to it. That he or that she that you're thinking of is God. So why not know it? And then be still and listen to the divinity, the beauty, the intelligence, the one presence, the one power that actually God is as that appearing he or she. Thank you. God is the fullness of life, infinitely. The fullness of love, infinitely. Divine presence, purpose, infinitely. Therefore, this he or she you're thinking of, because he or she is God, he or she is the infinite life, the infinite love, the infinite divine purpose that is God. You're looking at it in the guise of a human form, but there's no human form. It's imaginary. It's illusory. You are in the very presence of, as your friend or your love, your colleague, your neighbor, your family member, the him or her you're thinking of. You're in the very presence of the whole of life, the whole of love, the whole of purpose, the whole light of the infinite. Now, what are you going to do apart from listen? What are you going to do apart from love? What are you going to do apart from serve? Are you going to have a desire that this person does this or that, or doesn't do this or that? Are you going to have a sense of responsibility over this person? Or for this person? Or are you going to release God to be God? Are you going to know this person always? No matter what they know or no matter what they do or don't do, as God, truth. And the whole of truth. Not a little slice appearing as this person. Truth is indivisible. The whole of God is this person. Therefore, the whole of presence, the whole of intelligence, wisdom, the whole of beingness, the whole of purpose, is this person. And you are that also. So are you going to exercise a personal opinion about either him or her or you? Or are you going to know now that our sense of being knows nothing of God, nothing of truth? So why not listen instead of tell? Why not inquire? Who are you? Who are you? What's really going on here? What's really present here? What's really happening? What's the truthful purpose here? You begin to feel the truth of this?
I'd say I want to sing it.
Oh, we'd love you to sing it.
Thank you. These are life-changing things that, you know, thank you, Paul.
Thank you, Grant.
Makes it thank just, you. There's things that, concepts that stand in the way, you know, and it becomes so clear.
Thank you.
It changes the course of life.
Indeed. It awakens us to the truth of life.
It makes it very clear in a way. Again, words aren't so good. What needs to be done?
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you for hearing.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. All right, we'll take a break. At lunch, which probably will be at 1 or even earlier, who knows, the second hour, I'm going to sit, anybody who wants to sit in the healing presence, the healing light, anybody who wants healing, sit, we'll do it together.
Here?
Yeah.
The second hour of lunch.
Here. Yes. Just come on. I'll be here. And anybody who... The beach, you know, we could... But this is good. Just sit and receive. Sit and let. Okay? So we'll do that. But right now, let's have 45 minutes. It's 11 o'clock. 45 minutes. Keep awareness now of each other as nothing but God. As best we can. Okay, see you in 45 minutes.